The new gold rush in the digital world is all about renewable energy. If the smartest energy source is one that's abundant, cheap, and clean, then plants are a lot smarter than humans. In just 1 hour, more energy reaches the earth from the sun than is used by humanity in a whole year. Over billions of years, plants have evolved effective ways to harness this abundant source, absorbing light energy and storing it as sugars, a chemical energy supply that can be drawn upon as needed. In the case of plants, usable fuel is carbohydrates, proteins, and fats. Humans, on the other hand, are looking for liquid fuel to power cars and electricity to run refrigerators. But that doesn't mean we can't look to photosynthesis to solve our dirty, expensive, dwindling energy woes. Scientists have been trying for years to replicate the process, with the end result being electricity rather than glucose, and they have made some notable successes. To recreate the process that plants have perfected, an energy conversion system has to be able to do two crucial things. That is, to harvest sunlight and split water molecules. Plants accomplish these tasks using chlorophyll, which captures sunlight, and a collection of proteins and enzymes that use that sunlight to break down water molecules into hydrogen, electron, and oxygen. For an artificial system to work for human needs, output has to change. Getting the process to produce hydrogen is not a problem since it's already there in the water molecules, and capturing sunlight is also not a problem. Current solar power systems do that. The hard part is splitting the water molecules to get the electrons necessary to facilitate the chemical process that produces the hydrogen. That hydrogen could be easily used directly as liquid fuel or channeled into a fuel cell. Splitting water requires an energy input. This means the process requires a catalyst, something to get the whole thing moving. The catalyst reacts with the sun's photons to initiate a chemical reaction. Manganese disynthesized titanium dioxide and cobalt oxide has been used for these processes. Once perfected, these systems could change the way we power our world. Fossil fuels are in short supply, and they are contributing to pollution and global warming. Artificial photosynthesis, on the other hand, could produce a clean and storable fuel, and unlike most methods of generating alternative energy, artificial photosynthesis has the potential to produce more than one type of fuel. The photosynthetic process could be tweaked to either produce liquid hydrogen, or it could be funneled into a fuel cell setup, so we'd use it to run our air conditioning and water heaters. Methanol is another possible outcome. It is typically derived from the methane in natural gas, and it's often added to commercial gasoline to make it burn more cleanly. The ability to produce a clean fuel without generating any harmful byproducts like greenhouse gases makes artificial photosynthesis an ideal energy source for the environment. It is clearly a win-win situation. But while artificial photosynthesis works in the lab, it's not ready for mass consumption. Replicating what happens naturally in green plants is not a simple task. Plants took billions of years to perfect it. Replicating that in a synthetic system takes a lot of trial and error. Research in artificial photosynthesis is picking up steam, but it won't be leaving the lab anytime soon. But perhaps in 5 years? And that's a pretty hopeful estimate. Still, who can resist hoping for artificial plants that behave like the real thing? So friends, if you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.